Hi, everybody. I'm Katherine Jin, and I'm one of the co-founders of Kinnos, along with my two best friends, Jason and Kevin, who are sitting over there. So I'm going to tell you about our highlight Kinnos journey that began in October 2014. Jason and I were sitting together in class, and he got an email about the Columbia Ebola Design Challenge, which was a biomedical engineering hackathon that was looking for students to develop low-cost solutions for the crisis in Africa. But Jason and I both weren't that interested in going, mostly because that night was his 21st birthday. We had some pretty grand plans. But obviously, we went. This is actually the first time we pitched Highlight ever in 2014. And so despite our plans, and despite the fact we didn't know anything about infectious diseases or of epidemics, we learned that night the importance of saying yes and getting out of your comfort zone. So it's easy to spend a lot of time searching for the perfect invention, but oftentimes the best solution will come find you. So we learned that during the Ebola crisis, one of the major problems was ineffective decontamination. So healthcare workers are one of the highest groups that get infected. And this is horrible, especially in countries like Liberia and Guinea, where there's only 40 doctors for the entire country, where doctors are crucial to both stop an epidemic, but also are important in an already fragile healthcare system. So the current protocol looks something like this. You come out of a hot zone where you've just created some Ebola patients. You go to a doffing station where a hygienist sprays you down with bleach as you remove your waterproof PPE suit. And if you guys can't tell, that's me in Liberia getting doffed. So current disinfectants like bleach have three major problems. First, they're transparent, so you can't see where you're spraying. Second, they form droplets and roll off surfaces. So we've quantified that to actually only be 33% of the surface covered. And lastly, the disinfectants evaporate within 2 to 3 minutes, not hitting the requisite 10-minute contact time required to kill Ebola. So none of us ever set out in our undergraduate career to solve the problem of ineffective decontamination. So that brings me to my first point about inventing. Design for the problem, not for the solution. Invention is a lot more than designing cool apps or cool gadgets. It's about making a societal and humanitarian impact. So when we started out, we never thought we were going to incorporate. We never thought we were going to try and make revenue from this. Our goal was to deploy immediately a low-cost solution that could save lives. So what was our solution? Our solution was Highlight, a powdered additive you add to disinfectants at point of use. Highlight colorizes the solution so you can see where you're spraying. It also fully adheres and sticks to waterproof surfaces. So we got that 33% coverage up to 99.9%. And also it slows the evaporation time so you can maintain contact time to kill virus. Lastly, the color fades and that indicates to users when decontamination is complete and allows you to reuse materials. So once you spray your ambulance door or the walls of your room, that won't be blue forever. So in developing Highlight, it was full of pitfalls, as you guys can probably imagine. It required a lot of persistence and a lot of dedication. When we first thought of Highlight, it seemed like a pretty simple concept, right? We're making something that'll turn bleach blue. So we thought we were gonna get from point A to point B pretty easily. But as you guys probably know from your experience inventing, the trajectory looks something more like this. And obviously, we had a final concept or a final project in our mind, but the execution was what was difficult, both on the technology side, as you can see from our terrible, our terrible first prototype, and also on the personal side. So when we were first developing Highlight, we were contacted by the Fire Department of New York, and they wanted to demo Highlight at Mount Sinai Hospital. And that was one of the most exciting moments in the early development phases of this product. However, unfortunately, the next day, all three of us had a major organic chemistry exam. You guys do not need me to tell you how hard organic chemistry is. So we were in kind of a bind. How are we going to go to this demo and also study for your exam? So Jason actually stepped up, decided he was going to sacrifice the test, not study at all, and go to the demo. And that was actually one of the best decisions we've ever made. That was when the Fire Department of New York actually decided to buy Highlight, and that was the same night in the library stairwell we also decided to incorporate. So this is the real end of the story. Jason got a 16 out of 100 on the exam. But it also wasn't the lowest score of the class, so Orgo sucks. And from then, we all learned a lot about sacrifices. We've since sacrificed probably countless tests. maybe I think I've sacrificed like 4 or 5 class grades by now. For example, in junior year when we were writing our Ebola Grand Challenge grant for the USAID, we actually spent most of final season writing the grant instead of studying for finals. So while my grades weren't that good that semester, we ended up winning a grant that gave us over $500,000 to focus on research and development and really, you know, pushed us to put our product where it is today. So I'm not telling you, obviously, to go to school and get like 16 out of 100s. But I do want to emphasize that learning occurs outside of the classroom, as you guys probably know from inventing. And it's okay to have priorities that you find meaningful that you devote yourself to instead of metrics like grades or GPA. So another thing we learned during this process is that development or invention is iteration. So the most important thing is to test even when your product isn't perfect, even when it sucks. I just want you guys to remember the terrible rudimentary prototype we showed in the very beginning. So often we have a concept of what we want our prototype to look like or work like, but it's important to remember that as you invent, you're also learning. So for example, when we invented Highlight, we first just put dye in bleach, then we saw that horrible coverage problem. We then brought it outside for the first time after a horrible New York winter, and we saw the coverage problem, as well as the evaporation problem. And then we went to Liberia, and we saw the chlorine fumes problem. And it's important at each point of this iterative process to constantly also be interviewing your end users, because what you think they need is always very different from what they actually need. And this brings me to one of the most important parts of inventing, which is impact. So we actually just got back from Guinea. We are working with the International Medical Corps to implement Highlight in country. This is our second round of field testing. We went to Liberia last November, and it was one of the most incredible experiences to work with doctors and hygienists who had actually been there and put their lives on the line during the crisis. And they told us how they felt confident and much safer when they used Highlight, and they wanted it for the next epidemic. So I just wanted to speak really quickly about my own personal experience as an inventor. Growing up, I never thought I would be an inventor. In high school, I would never be at something like EurekaFest, not because of lack of interest, but because a whole myriad of reasons. For example, I didn't think I was smart enough, I didn't think I was good enough, and I didn't really have people in my life who encouraged me and my abilities to do so. And that brings me to something that I think is really important and something I'm really happy about, but I think it's amazing that there are so many female innovators in this room today. I tried to talk to all the girl teams, but yeah. And I want to speak about that. I think, as all of you know, we're often underestimated. Sometimes it's direct. I've had people tell me, you can't code because you're a girl. But I've also had a lot of moments that are subtle but are just as important. For example, once when I was representing Kinnos alone at a competition, I was registering at the front desk, and the whole time, all the event organizers kept telling me how brave I was for representing my company by myself. But right before me, a guy had walked up and registered, and he was representing his team alone. He didn't receive any of those comments. So it's easy as a girl to think, I'm being too sensitive, or I shouldn't worry about it, I should just brush it off. But I think it's really important to realize that's a problem. You're not being sensitive. So in that moment, I wasn't being brave. Pitching alone isn't any excellence as a female. Pitching is my job. And I think I've learned a lot about confidence, both being a woman and also about what I can learn and what I can do throughout this whole process. I think inventing is key. It's literally synonymous with taking risks. And how can you take risks without confidence? And what I've learned about confidence throughout this process is that personal confidence comes in two forms. First, it's what you can do. So this is stuff you learn in class. This is stuff your teachers teach you, what you do during research, what you've learned through this process. But also, there's the ever-important confidence in what you can learn to do, which is something that I've learned through my process of inventing. So Jason isn't a chemical engineer, Kevin isn't a chemical engineer, and neither am I, but we were able to develop a chemical blend. Now we can talk about chemical reactions if anyone wants to talk to us about them. And so I want to emphasize that in the future, you will never know how to solve every piece of the puzzle. You'll never know how to approach every problem that comes to you. But you should never doubt your ability to learn something that's difficult if you care a lot about it. So in the future, we're all graduated from Columbia. We actually just graduated. And we're implementing Highlight full time now. Our goal is to set the global standard for decontamination. And we want blue to be the reassuring marker of safety in the future. Thank you.